Alright, plane geometry problems involving complex numbers are sometimes like problem solving in that they'll need some lateral thinking in order to get to the solution. And as always, the more you practice these types of problems, the better you'll get at them. So let's have a go at this one. The point A in an Argand diagram represents the complex number 1 plus I. Find the complex number represented by B if OBA is an equilateral triangle and B is in the second quadrant. Now, to make sense of what this is saying, let's draw a diagram. Okay, we are given that A, which equals 1 plus I, obviously has the coordinates of 1, 1. So 1 on the real axis and then 1 on the imaginary axis. The point O is the origin. And the point B, we are told, lies in the second quadrant. So we need to find the coordinates of point B. We're told that O, B, and A form an equilateral triangle. Okay, so by definition, an equilateral triangle has three equal sides and three equal angles. And of course, the angles have to equal 60 degrees. So how do we use this knowledge to find the coordinates of point B? Well, since we know what A is, I can represent it using a vector from the origin, which I'm drawing in purple. And I'll call this vector Z1. And to get the coordinates of B, all I have to do is rotate this vector Z1 by 60 degrees to form this dashed vector pointing to the coordinates of B. And I can do this rotation through complex number multiplication. So we've established before that when you multiply two complex numbers together, say Z1 multiplied by Z2, the result is equal to the modulus of Z1 times the modulus of Z2 by sis of the addition of their arguments, or their angles. Now, since point B must have the same distance from the origin as point A, this vector here must have the same modulus as Z1. So to preserve the modulus of this vector, I would make the mod of Z2 equal to 1. And then to rotate this vector by 60 degrees, I would make the argument of the rotation vector equal to 60 degrees. So then B I can express as the product of Z1 by Z2, which is equal to the modulus of Z1 by sis of the angle of Z1 plus 60 degrees. And now this may be a little bit unconventional, but I'm going to say that this is equal to 1 plus I, which is what Z1 is, and then multiplied by sis of 60 degrees. So this is a combined Cartesian form and polar form multiplication. And of course, to perform the multiplication, I have to convert this into Cartesian form. So we have 1 plus I by the cosine of 60 degrees plus I sine of 60 degrees. And the cosine of 60 degrees is equal to 1/2 plus I, and the sine of 60 degrees is equal to root 3 on 2. And this is multiplied by Z1, which is 1 plus I. So expanding this out, I get 1/2 plus I by root 3 on 2 plus I by 1/2 plus I squared by root 3 on 2. And of course I squared is equal to negative 1. So the real component when I group them together is 1 minus root 3 all over 2. and the imaginary component is I by 1 plus root 3 over 2. And of course this is equal to B. So the coordinates of B I can express as 1 minus root 3 all over 2, comma 1 plus root 3 all over 2.